you might be thinking, really? Just the shoe? But let me tell you, that is a very powerful shoe. To give you an example, recently I was down at Walt Disney World at the Magic Kingdom, and being a Disney fan, I like to sample all of their new attractions, so I decided to brave the Storybook Princess meet and greet in the new Fantasyland. But I didn't want to use one of my FastPass Pluses on it because you only get three, and I say that with all due respect to anyone who would want to use one of their FastPass Pluses on the Storybook Princess meet and greet. But anyway, I had to do the regular standby line, and it was grueling. It was hot, it was crowded, and it didn't move. But at the end of that line, revealed to us was Cinderella's glass slipper in this beautiful case. It was just sparkling like you wouldn't believe, kind of like it sparkles in this teaser trailer for the Cinderella live action movie. And it really just took your breath away. In fact, I took a photo of it. Everybody who was online was taking a photo of it. And I'm putting up a picture right here that I took from the attraction queue, the waiting line. And it really was a special moment. I liked seeing that even more than the eventual princess meet and greet afterwards, which was right after you saw that sparkling glass slipper. And I think that it really underlines just how, while some people fall in and out of love with certain myths as they get older, women really love the Cinderella myth. It never loses its appeal. For instance, Pretty Woman is based on the Cinderella myth. And there's a famous line from that where Julia Roberts says, I want the fairy tale. And if this Cinderella live action movie can speak to that and create a version of the story that is sophisticated enough for older viewers, for full grown women, I think that Disney could really have something exciting on their hands. I'm surprised they debuted this trailer so early. I guess they're putting it in front of Million Dollar Arm. I would think it would debut the week that Maleficent is coming out to play in front of that. I'm sure it will play in front of Maleficent. But I'm very curious as to if that's the direction they're going to go in, because I was wondering what they could possibly do with this story that would warrant a live-action adaptation. Because, you know, it's not like Maleficent where they're doing it from the villain's point of view. It just seems to be a straight retelling, or so I had assumed. But it looks like perhaps they're really going to go full fantasy here, which could be quite lucrative for the Disney company. Now, there's also something that comes into play here is that butterfly, which came out of nowhere to me. It kind of broke the mood, actually, a little bit. I was enjoying the beautiful, swelling music. You know, it was very romantic, and the sparkly shoe. I was like, oh, I'm kind of into this. Although, I have to say, that is a ridiculously high heel, even for a regular shoe. You know, I'd be like, hey, fairy godmother, you have to also give me the ability to walk in those. Or it could become the Jennifer Lawrence of Cinderella movies as she trips down the entrance to the ball. But I was really enjoying it. But then the butterfly kind of floated in, and it was a little bit of a funny moment. It reminded me actually of Bridesmaids when Rose Byrne sends out those invitations with the butterfly. That was a great moment in that movie. I loved it. So that kind of took me out of it. But then I was like, okay, let's play the game. Why is Disney putting this in here? What's the point of the butterfly? So I thought to myself, what if it's the transformation aspect of Cinderella? What if they're going to play that up, which nobody really ever does. Even when Cinderella is in her rags, she always looks amazing. But what if they also played up the transformation idea, you know, from Pygmalion, My Fair Lady, which is also very powerful and also extremely popular with fans and particularly women of all ages. So I'd be interested if they have that come into play as well. I've seen photos of Lily James as Cinderella, or just one actually, that one that Disney put out. I guess maybe that's before, you know, she becomes under the sway of her evil stepmother, because she doesn't look like she has a lot of transforming to do. But I think Kenneth Branagh, who's directing here, would be very smart to play up both the Cinderella full fantasy aspect, a more sophisticated version for adults, and then also the transformation angle. That could be really exciting for Disney. Maybe perhaps even more so than Maleficent. We'll see what happens when Maleficent's released later this month. So I'm curious, was this teaser trailer enough for you? Was the shoe enough? If you've never understood the power of the shoe, do you understand it a little better now? And have you been to that attraction in Disney World, and were you equally taken with the glass slipper on display? Write your thoughts down below. Thank you for tuning into my review, and you can check out some more episodes right now.